So we can say that, you know, when people search for like apologize, we do it to be five feet instead. I'm just Google to be 5 feet instead. So if I on this device, I'm trying to go to like if I go to apologize. I forget to decide the center of God. So I got to redirect them, and if I go to some cases it works, if I go to Google, I should end up at the go the search engine. So I can, you know, redirect them to different machines, so I can actually try them to do get to Facebook, or, you know, if I go if I try to Facebook, I get to my page, I can see the login and see from there. So if I'm in the middle, I have full control over your traffic, and we'll go to all machines and so. And I mean, it's different. It's not so fun. It's actually a pineapple bomb. So you can actually download add-ons. So if you can get, you know, jammers and Guinness Proof and map and scanner, you can get keyloggers and I will inject a keylogger into pages that you'll view. So I can see what's type and other things. TV, Java, and all that. Search, factor add, transfer keys, and other things. So it'll be, and you can even get even add a 3G modem dongle that you will see one. You can actually get the 3G on the box as well. And just, you know, walk around the city and calling. So, see my shopping casino, whatever it's being made. And I'll be fun right now, but no. If you're patient and you're lucky, I'm sure you're happy with that. So I will not, you know, have you off now, so it's off. You have to keep it safe for the evening. So, what's next? So I can inject JavaScript. And this is really interesting because even if it's my own JavaScript into a page, I have full access to everything that you as a user have access to in your browser. I can see your cookies, I can see your computer, I can, you know, look at keyboard typing, I can send things to you, you know, if that's your laptop, accessing your hard drive, I can sort of backing other machines inside your network or somewhere else. And so I think, you know, so, this is on the page. I start entering some beef. My sewer and the seniors and just, you know, under and credit card and so on. I do actually nothing suspicious here. But if I, in a different browser, go to inside my command control center, I actually see this, my browser here connected to it. And if you, anyone else want to try, you have to go to this IP address, it's not dangerous. You actually use this address in your phone and, you know, see what happens. Because the thing that's going to happen is that first of all, I can see what I'm typing. I have full load, reactive on a page. I type in a number, I have a credit card. I have full real time visibility in what I'm going to do on this page. So if I go back to this page here, I'm typing something. And I go back to this page and check it off again. I see my types. So what is really happening under the hood? If you look at Fiddler, if I don't know what Fiddler, that's all good. So it locks my traffic on the web. And you see here, what does call the cookie.js? It's my thief ordering page that's actually calling home to my command control server for an asking for, you know, things to do. So because it's constantly on the second step, you know, what to do. So in theory, I can have, you know, on this page here, the hundreds of devices and browsers hooked to my browser. So if I want to see what to my thief page, you can actually end up here and I can start seeing what's on that page. So that's something I'm obsessed with, but we're evil. So I can go to the command section and I can also look at, you know, commands that I can apply to a central browser. I can see if it works. I've got them back here. So I have this, you know, links here. And we see that the first one here is go to deepproject.com and a link to slash dot, here's the bottom slash dot, this link here. So let's see, so I can actually try to replace all links with something else. So I can replace it with, you know, run the execute. I've got a command to my to the browser. And by not doing anything, if I'm lucky, the links should change. In real time, I'm not really sure if this will work, but you know, if I'm lucky, it should work. Or, I think you guys configured correctly, and you know, you're in a way where you can actually start on SMM, join me. So, then if that person now enters in a form, I can see what he was doing. So, the command here for kind of, you know, modifying the page, I can do the other service, and effectively a core network, it's a Kingsley, if I have Java, I get a single link of my network into a port scan, and another hacks against the browser. And do various exploits about hacking cameras, D-Link, things like cameras, you have that in the network, and other things. So, as the browser looks at my botnet, I have inside a firewall, so I can start doing, you know, requests to other machines on the local internet. On your browser, with your credentials, your Active Directory credentials, and nobody will notice, just like you, and I was remote controlling your browser. And I can, you know, make a load of automation for the night frame, and if you click along with that, in the background, you know, listening to super traffic. So it's pretty kind of scary, and the easiest thing here is an open source demonstration setup. Get download and start, you know, supporting yourself and to learn more about, you know, cross-site scripting and the probabilities of, you know, getting even JavaScript into your page. So, yes, so this page, in the source code, there is a link here to Hook.js, but it takes from the same site as loaded from. So, that's all. I can escape this Hook.js, so if I can get friendly characters into the page, I can start controlling your browser sometime. So, it's really a scary place, and there's many more attacks that we can, you know, get, you know, you get up the tech line. So I'm definitely in favor of civilization, because it really shows and highlights the issue here. And so, you know, so nothing is evil. And what we can do for some people, if you have a Firefox, you can use the NoScript add-on. Everyone running NoScript. So do you. So, I think that is hard enough. So NoScript. So what you tell is second by default blocks all JavaScript, and you have to whitelist and enable side-by-side basis. So at the beginning, it was a bit annoying to enable JavaScript but the thing is that you objectify this kind of, you know, if you happen to get to a really bad site by mistake, and then you will not see, you will not execute that JavaScript. So if I'm a hacker and I want to get JavaScript into as many browsers as possible, how do I do that? I mean, what's easy to get JavaScript into the browsers? And yes, secret way, it's by advertisement. I think it's a manufacturing agency, some, you know, not like JavaScript or the big one, not one, you know, more one, because the big one, but then I'm going to have to show you, it's a huge value, you know, of network, and see if we can get something out to fill the inventory with, and if I don't have something, go to the next one. And if you go to someone that's not going to check your channels in a good way, then you better get through the network. Or something you have to go to the site directly and say, I want to buy a van on the site, you know, I want to charge him. And you pay them and they send some JavaScript, maybe you need five options in this, so you know, they can check what it does, and, you know, in the beginning maybe it looks good, but they change it, something else, and then, you know, you get, you know, collecting the goods. So, then on that, it's a really effective platform to deliver, you know, to JavaScript to your browser. So I can connect this. Well, you can look at, you know, the type of how you're not secure or not. This is a secure site, and this is going to be a possibility. It pretty shows you your state. And for VPN servers, this is another way that you use to really check it, you know, to have a secure communication between you and your company. And let's see, let's just the beginning or, you know, the time frame. It's usually pretty hard to set up and configure and maybe too annoying for the end users. Another thing that we as a web user can do is cycle fingerprinting. And we're going to check it out on our page here, and I'll show you quickly. So fingerprinting is something where it's the browser, and you do them, you know, you check the memory of operating system, the format you have in both plugins, and you combine them, and you make like a hash value of that data. And I got the slide there. Somewhere. Yeah, so in theory, I can do a simple JavaScript. But iterate through my navigator, copy the JavaScript, and for each property, makes a long string, and then you can get the hash code of that string. And then you can get that identifier for that browser. And if you're logged in, for some reason, you know, this value changes. That's what we are in. Usually don't change the browser while you're surfing, so that could be an indicator that someone is hacking your possession. It's like if some user goes into the site and changes the user agent and creates a header, that's also a time that something, you know, bad happened. So, this simple JavaScript, if you run it in different browsers, you'll get different values, and if you record this value when you're logged in, and then check it once in a while, you can detect if the browser is, has moved to a different platform, and that you will not be allowed, and we can have to log in again. And to get, you know, more details, I can. And if I do this from a navigator object, I can get information like this. You can get, you know, name, version, language, Wi-Fi, plugins, user agent, cookies enabled. And for most browsers, these are different values. Not many browsers have exactly the same setup here. And if you want to be in more detail, you can actually look at the screen object itself as well. And then you can get, you know, the pieces of size and monitors and those are also break down by between machines. So, many kind of, you know, financial and Skype and other companies using this to make sure that they're not, you know, an attack or being used by, you know, fraud or something like that. And with a few commercial, you know, things with the companies. But if you want to try this yourself, there is a source site called Panopticlick, Panopticlick, I think this, if I'm not wrong. It's a factory. So this is by the Electronic Frontier Foundation. And you can make a test of the browser to determine how unique your the browser is. And I'm going to load this one and let you to enable. So I think you should see some more of the three different browsers that promise that. So this is the setting. And it says here that my browser fingerprint appears to be unique among the 4 million tested browsers. So it's a pretty kind of unique my browser here. So just by checking my screen and navigation and other properties, I can get a pretty good pinpoint of that I am me. So I'm thinking that it's really, really hard for me to be anonymous on the web and hide my identity, because they can track me in many different other ways. So I can see here that what they can have based on, so user agents, accept headers, browser plugins, time zone, font, system fonts, cookies enabled, and other things. So it's this kind of script, quite a lot of data to make the check some on. So it's really going to be hard to be to try to hide your identity on the web, because they can track you anyway. So if I should ask you a question about fingerprinting, when before. So this fingerprinting is one way where you, your image is on the web service and some of the web page time. You can do something to have like the public key in your client, and you make your connections to an encrypted site. You make your checks to public key against your hard public key in your client, and you can determine if the certificate is, you know, genuine or not. So that's one way of, you know, to harden the communication between if you have like a web client and a web service or something. So it's not really, really hard to do even code if you want to do this. Showdown, I'm not sure how to do it. It's really, really fun things. So on the web, where VLS website, security system, extends your of searching and imaging that space. But the web contains so much more information. We have website host, we have web cameras, we have scale systems. Scale systems are industrial control systems performed in the industry. And for software only for hackers. We have factories, you know, power plants, machinery that is, you know, exposed on the web. Traffic lights, power plants, like, I mean, routers, switches, printers, you name it. There's so much more on the web. And the Google does not search this space, but show them does. Show them will search this space and find all of these devices for you and search in the app and make a search for the friendly user interface. So, how does it work? So, Showdown will go from IP address to IP address, scan the entire web. It will provide each IP address, check the ports and some other ones, and do a banner grab. So, what's a banner grab mean? Well, it's it needs to get my Facebook service, and it's, you know, on that port for that IP address. And the banner is the, you know, welcome or hello message, but the service will return when you make you know, a bad request to it. Like a website will return with something like this, you know, if you connect to it. And always go to the NetP so you can get some idea of, you know, domain or version or sorry, it's a database, you get some details about the database. So it's like a friendly text message that the service will return back to you if you connect to it. So Showdown will